Good morning, good evening, good day, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the Scout Build, where we build our own sailing and rowing magnificent performance dinghy. That's to be seen yet. My name is Aladino. My wife and I, we are currently on a mission to restore Cape George Cutter 36. We're hoping to sail around the world on it. So in order to get on and off the boat, you also require a smaller boat, which is known as the tender or the dinghy. And this is where the Scout comes into play.
The Scout is a beautiful 10-foot rowing and sailing dinghy that Aladino is building using a kit supplied by a small company called Duckworks.
This is the kit.
That's the kit. So in the last episode, we opened the box. I didn't quite know what was in store for us. It was the first time for me opening such a kit. A lot of beautifully CNC'd pieces. Yeah, it was just really cool for me to see where technology is going. And then we did most of the mise en place, all of the prep work, building the components that later on in this episode will be assembled to actually make a three-dimensional structure. Or, in other words, the boat. The bow jig is on, the stern jig is on the table now. I have put some duct tape on them because I will be gluing the planks together and I don't want the boat to stick to the jigs. And I've also glued the jigs themselves down to the table with hot glue. Everything is straight and square and true and all of that. Next is starting with the assembly. The first step was assembly of the keel. It slots into these two cutouts and then there is the pre-drilled holes for the zip ties. This dinghy is built by using the stitch and glue method. So basically you're doing a dry fit assembly of all the parts using zip ties. And those zip ties hold the shape of the boat and then you replace the zip ties by epoxy glue, basically.
The boat is about to take shape. After over 60 hours of assembly and prep work to get to this point, it's a pretty exciting moment as plank by plank, zip tie by zip tie, it all comes together.
I have personally never assembled a stitch and glue project before, so this is gonna be interesting. We are on quite of a time crunch, so it is actually very exciting to see this step come together so quickly. As recommended per manual, only tighten them loosely. So since the jig doesn't extend much further up here and the second plank wouldn't be supported, I think I'm gonna continue with the transom and this will help us put on the remaining planks. Let's try this. So there's these alignment notches and there's the holes here. Very simple at this stage. I couldn't believe how satisfying this step was, as it took me like 60 hours to get all the parts prepared, but then in maybe under an hour I got
basically almost the whole boat together and zip tied into its final shape.
There's something strange about this. Usually everything takes so long, and this is so much quicker to already, like, seeing it. Yeah, that's pretty cool. Alright, let's continue. Plank number two. This is moving along way too quickly. Panels, all the planks are on, and it's looking mighty cool. Plank 2 and 3, they are lap strike, and that means they overlap. Yeah, it still is all zip tied very loosely, so now actually the manual recommends throwing it in the water and testing it. No, I'm just kidding.
And Dad has come to see what's
well, what's today's been going the on. First day that Aladino has put in a lot of preparation work in getting all the individual panels together. It's a game of patience because it's also a game of delayed gratification. But today is the day where all that work has shows a good deal of gratification because it's a beautiful looking dinghy. It looks great.
Now we have an empty shell, and there's many more components going in, from bulkheads to longitudinal partitions supporting the deck, and more. The cockpit design of this boat appealed to me especially. I think it is pretty cool to have the daggerboard offset, and you have the entire cockpit well. You can potentially inflate a mattress, or even just grab your sleeping bag and sleep in there. It gives a lot of storage on the sides where the seats are. The seats, when you're rowing, they can be configured easily and changed position. And it's also a great place to stretch out and maybe sit in when you're sailing the boat. So the deck doubler is in place now too. Now what does this do? It creates a bit of a wide gluing surface for the foam decks that will go on. So that is one reason, and the other one is this becomes kind of a box-like construction that strengthens the area where the mast goes through. And then there's one more, this one here, and it goes in at the very bow. Big Lego. Today is a really good day. It's really nice how quickly this all came together, but I am also anticipating a few things that I am a bit wary about. Next few steps have gotten me a bit worried. All right, so I've been fiddling around a little more. The zip ties are further tied together because as everything comes together and you're certain about the position, then you go back and the manual says to start at the bottom to tighten it all up. So we are at that stage now. I've done a few minor modifications. I've placed two wedges in here So it does spread plank number two out a little bit, because otherwise, because of the lapstrake here, it just wants to continually fall over. And another thing, putting in a quarter inch rod here at the stem, and that really helps align the planks. There's this one area here where I still have a gap, and there is the most tension here in the bow. So this is one place where I actually want to try wire instead of zip ties, just to see if I can bring those panels in a little closer. At this point I remove the zip tie. As you can see, I'm prepared for the messy part, and I'll try to keep it as tidy as possible. The next step would be putting in fillets so that the epoxy would finally glue the shape together, and that is always a bit nerve-wracking because of course you don't want things to shift on you, for one, and also I was worried that this step would be messy. Well, and I'm a little weird in the sense that I also get satisfaction from just seeing cool tape in symmetrical fashion on a boat. Putting epoxy in between the zip ties so that tomorrow or the day after, when the boat is fully held together by the epoxy, I can remove the zip ties, and then at the end we will do the aesthetically pleasing nice fillets.
This is a critical step to the success of the boat. Once epoxied together, it will no longer be possible to adjust the shape and symmetry, so Aladino checked and triple-checked before finally applying this first layer of epoxy.
Good morning! The epoxy has cured. I'm very happy how this step went. Now, ladies and gentlemen, more epoxy, you've guessed it. Alright, shall we do this?
Alright.
A fillet is welding with epoxy. When you have, for example, two pieces joining, you add a 90-degree curve.
With no more zip ties in the way, Aladino applied the final epoxy seams.
My taste, this is clearly an application for slow hardener. After the priming is the fairing and the fillet and then the glass and then the peel ply, so it gives me enough time and I don't have to stress about having batches of epoxy hardening. Especially when you're doing fillets, it's bigger quantities, so it's nice to have the extra time. Well, once you start, there's no turning back, and that's where the nervousness also starts easing off, because, yeah, you start doing it and you go like, oh, that wasn't such a big deal, was it? I have done all the prep work, the boat was in the right shape, so it's starting to happen. So the boat is now waterproof, and yeah, that feels pretty good, even though I wouldn't want to put it in the water quite yet. So just like the zip tying, this step was also relatively quick, but ahead are many tedious little tasks, so we're still far from complete. Next is gluing on this piece of foam, which creates the inwale. Well, yeah, that's a thing I don't know in English, but you write it gunwale, but I think then you pronounce gunnel. So I don't know, this one being an inwale, if then you pronounce it innel. But anyway, as you can see now, the sides are very flexible. So if you just approach the mothership with a little bit of swing, then you might crack the fragile, thin plank. So this here stiffens up the shear up here, and it's also where the oars are installed, so it has to be very stiff. Also, I'm trying to speed up the process a little bit because I built 99 hours, but the boat ain't done.
Oh my god, Aladino.
The inwale, it's encapsulated by plywood, and after the corners are rounded over and everything is glued, then it's all glassed over. Another thing that I found plays an important role here is the breast hook, because it actually spreads the sides of the hull outwards a little bit, and that gives the shape of the bow, which helps at the end put on the caps. So I think I'll glue this in now, and then the rest of the evening I'm just going to be dry fitting the top cap and the bottom cap until they fit nicely, and then it's just some more gluing.
By the way, it is Christmas Eve currently. He is insisting on working in the shed, and so is he. This is my brother, ladies and gentlemen. So both me and Dylan's girlfriend, Kirsten, are both like, what the heck, guys? But here they are in the workshop. Anyway, you guys are both making good stuff. Dylan, what are you making?
Currently I'm making a necklace for a customer. An order, it's a piece of padauk with green pigment, glow-in-the-dark powder, and meteorite shavings.
Groovy.
And then I just finished a couple of custom rings made of titanium, copper, and true stone.
Cool.
Nice. Well, put in a little plug. Tell them where to find you and show them maybe the knife, because you make awesome stuff.
Edit out this bit.
What?
Edit out, just like, don't have this one clip. Like, edit this out right now.
Why?
Because
why?
No. Take off.
You don't want advertising?
Take off.
You're busy enough. You're exclusive.
This will, like, lower your views. But here, if you can, is it silhouetted?
There's a knife that Dylan's made.
This is out of a recycled Nicholson file with canvas micarta scales and black spinel gemstone in the center there with brass hardware.
And you cannot order one because the man's too busy.
Well, you can. You might just have to wait a little bit. But I am always making things.
So can they order something, Dylan?
Yeah. They just have to
How?
Wait. Go on my Instagram.
Which is what? Guys, I thought you were bad.
It just takes some warm up.
It's Instagram link down below. No, it's Coastal EDC or Wooden Edge Designs is where you'll find my work.
All right.
Cool. We'll
this is gonna be out. One clip.
I don't know. We'll see. It's kind of funny. Merry Christmas.
Ridiculous. Thank you.
the more the project went on, the more I felt the time crunch. I took a few days off during Christmas. We had some events, but yeah, the project was sure forefront on my mind all the time, so I was pretty stressed. I returned to the workshop and I had an ever-growing list of little tasks ahead of me. Many of them were about the in-whale, but there were many other pieces that were starting to take shape. So yeah, I was moving amongst different projects. So I thought I could hang up the boat and do the inside fillets. By inside fillets, I mean the one that goes inside the in-whale. Remember, glass never likes harsh radiuses, so not a 45 degree angle. Instead, I'll put in a fillet right there. It is one thing after another. So now I'm gonna hit it with the orbital sander real quick. Many of the steps that I was working on now did not have that quick reward like some of the initial work, but even though I was getting slightly more frustrated, I am quite used to it, because when I do this kind of work in the boatyard, you're doing it for someone else, on someone else's boat. That's basically what you do. So yeah, I listen to my music and work away. I'm pretty good at that, but there was less reward in it instantly, that's for sure. The phenolic tubes, I believe these are made out of paper, soaked in resin, rotated into a tube, which is very precise. The inner diameter and the outer diameter are perfect, and it's pretty hard. It's a good way of strengthening a hole wherever you have a bolt going through, or yeah. The breast hook is located at the very bow of the boat. It's a horizontal cap. It has the same function like the knees in the back, where it takes out any movement, any wobble. It spreads the in-whale open, but it also strengthens the whole area tremendously. The challenge with the breast hook cap is that, to me, it looks much nicer if it has a curvature to it, especially on this boat and this design. It's nothing that is mentioned in the manual, but I just thought it would look good instead of having it flat, and it makes sense with all the other shapes on the boat, how they were coming together. I glued on the initial piece and I glued it on a little raised so that once the epoxy was cured, I could come back later and shape it a bit, and that shape would later on support the cap in the desired shape, and then I could just clamp it down onto the shaped foam. The boat has been in the oven for quite a while, so time to remove the clamps. The breast hook looked pretty good when I took the clamps off. It's one of those components that ties it all together. It's a pretty cool atmosphere in this little shop. Dylan is working here, and every now and then, at regular intervals, Brian comes visit, so we have a little chat, and yeah, overall, it's good times in here. So after glassing over the in whale, it was time to cut the excess glass off. And it was very satisfying to have it cut so easily. I haven't worked with such thin 4-ounce glass a lot. So even though it was cured, just taking an X-Acto knife and running along the tape, it worked out effortlessly. So it was pretty tedious to prepare all of these components, but now that they were completed and coming together, it was rewarding to put in one piece after the other. Tonight was a night of a lot of small tasks. One has to prepare and think ahead with epoxy. It's not like, oh, I got some spare epoxy, let me use it somewhere. The area has to be sanded, the amines have to be removed if there is any, depending what epoxy you use, and the temperatures and all that. But very often, yeah, there's quite a bit of prep work involved. I have been working on the boat for 150 hours to this stage. Of course, that's very individual. I heard somewhere that the boat could be completed in 120, and maybe some have, depending on the shop, depending on the skill. But also, I think it might reflect on the end result a little bit. I totally agree that it could be done. But as I said, it is an individual thing, depending on how it's approached. I'm getting really close now to applying primer, so yeah, I'm overall pretty happy from where the boat is at, and that it will look very different soon. And I cannot emphasize more, even though I'm close to ready to putting on primer, it's all about the prep work. So again, I did a whole lot of cleanup, some sandpaper with the scrapers, just make everything smooth and nice because it's all visible in your final primer and paint job. The in whale has been glassed over, and luckily I'm still within the recoat window, so I'm adding fairing compound on top of that to achieve the nice smooth aesthetic. When you hit the ground, I can recall the time and place on the midnight walk. So of course it doesn't look good right away, but the epoxy is that liquid that it will still settle. Back to the days when all the things we knew were made of gold. As the world moves on, time sings a song. Magic of fast forwarding, it's done. Time sings a song. Don't cry. Don't cry. Fiberglassing the bottom is to achieve a couple of things. You are waterproofing the boat, you're considerably strengthening the entire plank, and it's adding especially chafe and scratch resistance. Arranging the glass on the bottom of the boat was a bit of a challenge.
What I am actually now trying to figure out is how much glass do I have? And so since I have to wrap it twice, so to speak, where do I want the glass to overlap? I have worked it into place where I want it on that side of the boat, and it's really nice
and all the wrinkles taken out, and it's laying as it should. So then I think now at the moment that I would be trimming it about here. And then imagine that I roll another sheet of glass and I do the same thing but opposite sides. So then I'm getting glass once everywhere where I want it and twice on the bottom. And I also didn't quite know how much glass I would still have on the roll, but it all worked out pretty well in the end. Again, what it takes to do a good fiberglass job is time and patience. Slow movements, you know where you place one hand and where you have to stretch the glass to get the wrinkles out, and you really do want to get bigger particles out away from underneath the glass. All that little prep work ahead pays off later. I'm so excited! glassing went very well yesterday evening. I had my worries about one area, but it ended up coming out perfectly. So I'm super happy, and we are yet one step closer to completion. The next thing is adding a fill coat. I have two options. One is adding fairing compound, but fairing compound is softish to make sanding easier. And instead, down here at the bottom, I want something that is strong, hard, and scratch resistant. So I am instead thinking about adding a fill coat of just pure epoxy without filler. So there was a lot of assembly in this section of the build, a lot of small parts, but they're all in there now. And next I can start with primer and paint and all what comes. And it's really hard to foresee how much has been done yet and how much is still ahead, because so much is in the prep work and there's still a lot of prep work within every step that is coming ahead. So. Yeah, I don't know how much is still ahead, but a good portion is done now. Thanks so much, everybody, for watching. There is one more episode coming where we will finalize the build, which I am super, super excited about. So thank you all for watching, subscribing, being with us here next Friday. Huge thanks to our patrons. We couldn't do this without you. And an extra, extra big thank you to the names now appearing on the screen for going above and beyond to making sure that we can keep creating these episodes for you. If you enjoy these episodes, please consider becoming a Patreon. There are real-time updates every Tuesday. And yeah, we got a whole community on there of great people. See you all next Friday.